Do you know what the European Union is going to do to support the European automotive industry? Since the origins of the automobile, this industry has been a symbol of prosperity and pride for the continent. Now, with the rapid transition to electric, connected, and autonomous vehicles, the industry is undergoing significant change as manufacturing new cars in Europe has become increasingly costly and complex. This is due to factors such as dependence on raw materials and batteries from other countries, difficulties in attracting talent to these new factories, and the current geopolitical instability, among other reasons. But instead of standing still, the European Union is stepping up with a bold action plan built on five key pillars to support this industry. Today, what new car buyers value most is the in-vehicle experience, both for themselves and their passengers. If Europe wants to remain competitive in the world, it needs to regain its leadership in the development of connected and autonomous vehicles based on software and artificial intelligence. From 2026, test beds for autonomous vehicles will be created in three major areas covering several EU countries. 2. Clean mobility. In order to achieve climate neutrality by 2050, transport emissions must be reduced by 90%. However, this transition must be managed wisely. A flexibility mechanism has been introduced to ensure that the transition to clean vehicles is both economically viable and fair for all. Investment in infrastructure is also crucial to the competitiveness of the European automotive sector. To tackle this, a significant investment of 570 million euro will be made to install more charging stations and support other alternative fuel projects. 3. Competitiveness and supply chain resilience. The plan includes a significant boost to the battery sector. The European Commission has announced up to 3 billion euro from the Innovation Fund to support companies manufacturing them in Europe, with the possibility of adding state aid to support and accompany the development of a thriving European battery value chain with key components made in Europe. Recycling of raw materials will also be promoted, and regulations on the end of life of vehicles will be updated to facilitate their reuse. 4. Skills and social dimension. The European Commission will establish an observatory for a just transition. Its role will be to gather information and employment across the entire European automotive sector in order to identify potential areas where job losses could occur, allowing measures to be taken before they happen. 5. Level playing field and business environment. The automotive industry is a global business. Exporting, importing, and investing are crucial to ensuring that Europe remains competitive. For success, it is essential that European companies have access to foreign markets, can compete on equal terms, and operate in a favorable environment. That is why Europe will diversify its supply sources and ensure access to markets in other countries. Additionally, it will continue negotiating free trade agreements and forging new alliances to open up more opportunities for the European automotive industry. Now the question is for you. Do you think the European automotive industry will be able to adapt to these new challenges that have emerged in recent years?
Share your thoughts in the comment section and don't forget to subscribe.